Dear friends, a few days from now, on the 26th of January, we will all celebrate Australia Day. A day where we remember those who have gone before us, who stood in this land across the nations to keep Australia free and democratic. It's our duty this Australia Day to stand up for our nation, so that we will protect Australia and keep Australia great for generations to come. I want to title this message, The Enemy Within. We all look at situations from outside who might come and attack us. But there's an enemy right inside the nation. When I say that, we'll immediately all think of Islam and Islamic terror. That's a part of it. But I find that the greatest enemy for our own country, against democracy, right now I will identify it as the socialist, left, fascist movements which are within the country. These groups of people currently are clearly showing who they are in the United States of America. When Obama got elected, in both elections, in 2012 and 2008, even though the right of politics were very upset with his election, we did not have any violence, we did not have any demonstrations, we didn't have any trouble in the country. But as soon as Donald Trump is elected, who is on the right side of politics, all hell is breaking loose, and the true colors of people within the country who are not for democracy, but for a left agenda, which is very much influenced the communist ideology, socialist impact, are all out to destroy the democracy that we enjoy. But in there are also Islamic leaders who don't seem to be Muslims, but who are definitely sympathizers or prominent leaders amongst their community. One such advocate, you'll watch it on our Facebook, is a woman who is like second in command, who organized the rally against Donald Trump, calling on 200,000 people to come into the Capitol to protest against his election. This woman supports Sharia law, and she's seen enjoying meetings with Hamas and so on. So let's be very watchful. This Australia Day, be proud to be an Australian. It saddens me when I see people burn the Australian flag. Governments should be more proactive, not covering up and just turning a blind eye, but actually standing up and saying, if you burn the Australian flag, you go to jail. Show loyalty to your country. What level do we go to in democracy to crush democracy? We can't. We've got to stand up. I put two flags on my car starting Sunday, and I'll tell you what, I have not seen one vehicle with the Australian flag up to now. On the contrary, I see people looking at me like, whoa, who is this guy who has two flags on his car? And then they see a black fellow celebrating Australia Day. They are shocked. There's nothing to be shocked about. Every single person who comes into this country should embrace this country. If they think where they come into is bad, and where they come from is good, pack up and get out. Because if you love this country, celebrate Australia Day. We've got to unite a nation. We cannot divide a nation. We are here to become Australian and be a part of this country. If that's hard, tough luck, mate. Find another place. Go back to where you came from. So this Australia Day, I wish you a happy Australia Day. Be proud to put the Australian flag up on your car, mount it up in your house, wear the Aussie caps and walk around. Don't let the lefties intimidate you or frighten you. Stand up for what you believe, stand up for your country, stand up for the next generation. Let's keep Australia great for generations to come. God bless Australia.